Hi, my name is Dave. Welcome back to our YouTube channel. In our previous video, we showed you how to set up your router in repeater mode. But before we go into that, please like, share, and subscribe, and please put any comments or questions in the comment section below. We received feedback from our customers saying their SSID didn't appear in their Wi-Fi list. This might be happening for a number of reasons. One, the main router may be too far away. Two, the main router may be hiding the SSID. Three, you may be on the wrong Wi-Fi channel. Or four, the SSID may be in DFS mode. Many customers have their routers in their bedroom, office, or other area of their house. In this case, they sometimes can't find their SSID or connect to it. We suggest that when you're trying to set up your repeater, that you move closer to your main router to ensure better connectivity. And then we also suggest that you put your router in a higher position, such as on top of a bookcase or a cabinet. If you're still not connecting, we suggest you move on to the second stage, which would be your main router may be hiding your SSID. To ensure you can find your SSID, we suggest that you modify your SSID visibility in the main router on your main admin panel. For example, if you use GL.iNet router as your main router, you can change the SSID visibility to show in the wireless section. So you may ask that my router is able to scan for a 2.4G Wi-Fi, but I cannot find my SSID. This is because your Wi-Fi is on the wrong channel. Our routers use channels 1 to 11 for 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi by default. This applies to countries like the United States. When the Wi-Fi you want to repeat is on channels 12, 13, or 14, your router may not be able to repeat them. An example would be is that Japan supports channels 12, 13, or 14. If you want to change your country code to Japan, you'll need to change this in Luci to get full access to these channels. This method applies to all routers, except Mango, Beryl, and Micro Router N300. Here we use Slate as an example. Go to More Settings, click Advanced. Install Luci after connecting to the internet. Input the admin panel password and you will enter the Luci page. Go to Network, select Wireless. Click Edit on the 2.4G Wi-Fi section. Click Advanced Settings. Change the country code to your country or Japan. Click Save and Apply. Go back to the admin panel and reboot your router. Click Wireless, you will see the 12, 13, 14 section in the 2.4G Wi-Fi channel. Adjust the Wi-Fi channel. Scan again, and now you will be able to see other SSIDs. For Mango, Beryl, and MicroRouter N300 routers, you will need to change the country code using SSH. Here we will use Beryl as an example. First, SSH to your router. Please click the video here for step-by-step how to SSH to your router. Please type the following. For Mango and MicroRouter N300 routers, the command is different from Beryl. We put the command in the video description for your reference. Then input reboot. Wait for 30 seconds. Go back to the admin panel and you will see 12-13 section in the 2.4G Wi-Fi channel. Scan again. And you will now be able to see the other SSIDs. Our last situation is the SSID is in DFS mode. In this case, the router is set up in dynamic frequency selection mode and is not available for selection within the repeater. This is not a hardware issue, but actually a certification issue. In many countries, regulations may limit the number of 5 GHz channels available. This is because the spectrum is shared with many other technologies or services. Our devices are not tested for DFS certification and we disable the DFS functionality within our user interface. If you want an advanced function, you can use SSH on the router and configure it to use Luci. Still can't find your SSID? I also recommend that you type in your SSID into your admin panel. Click Internet, click Scan in the repeater section, choose Other in the drop-down list of SSID, type in the SSID you want to connect to. Click Join. You should be able to connect to it successfully. Just a warm reminder to please keep your firmware up to date and the latest version. If we did not solve your problem or you have any technical questions, please email us at our customer support email, which is available in the description, or please leave a comment or a question in the comments section down below. I hope this video has been helpful, and have a nice day. Bye-bye.